Daddy would tell us a story about how they got me. And he said they drove to Gainesville, and he climbed up on a ladder, and he looked down into the room where all these baby girls were in cribs. And he picked out the prettiest baby girl in there, and that's how they picked me.
That was Lisa Floyd's bedtime story, the story of how she was adopted by the Floyd family in 1963. Her mother and father turned to the Hampton Hall home for pregnant teens because they were desperate for a family. They had every reason to believe adopting baby Lisa was on the up and up. What the Floyds did not know was that the home where they found Lisa had been on the radar of police. Action News obtained court documents that show the home, while under a different name, had been linked to a terrible crime, selling babies on the black market. Lisa was one of those babies, and because her adoption was a black market baby sale, she ran into trouble trying to find her birth mother.
They're not going to hand over their files showing that they have been doing something illegal for 20 years.
Lisa fought for answers and eventually persuaded a Putnam County judge to hand over her birth mother's name.
Strickland, L-I-N.
Within days of getting that name, Lisa found a woman with her birth mother's name on Facebook.
I just said, I was looking for Sandra Strickland, who lived in Gainesville in the 60s. Are you her? I wrote back. I said, yes, you've got me.
Lisa had found her mother.
She wrote that she had never stopped thinking about me and loving me.
Every January, I thought about it and I wondered, is she happy? Did I do the right thing?
After so many years lost between mother and daughter, Lisa refused to waste any more time.
It was a long drive.
She and her husband drove from their home in Putnam County to North Carolina for an emotional family reunion. Lisa admits her mind was racing during that 8-hour drive.
Just wondering what we would talk about and how we would feel.
Sick. Is she gonna like me?
8 hours away, Sandra Strickland was also worrying. She tried to forget the time she spent at that home for unwed girls.
I block out things I don't like.
But she never forgot her daughter. So when she first laid eyes on Lisa...
Now, I knew who she was immediately. I mean, if you knew my mother and my father, she is a combination of the two of them.
For the first time, mother and daughter embrace. But Sandra wasn't the only one awaiting Lisa's arrival. Six brothers and sisters, most here to welcome Lisa home. Liz Burgess is one of them. Just watching them sit around a table, you'd think they'd known each other for years. Laughs, smiles, and already telling stories.
I remember you coming into the house, and it was like a receiving line of sorts, but there were so many people. And you had this deer in the headlights look.
Lisa's part of the family now.
She's now official.
I'm official.
And Lisa's just glad she can finally see a reflection of who she really is.
Of the seven children, Lisa looks more like my mother than any of us.
I would not have looked, searched, because I wouldn't want to intrude on her life, but I'm glad she intruded on mine.
Me too.